Greetings. This is the mastering tutorial that I promised. I'm gonna master something that I did now today, a couple of, well, an hour ago or something. I was just gonna throw together something complete rubbish here, but it ended up sounding pretty good. So I'll probably finish that and make a track out of that. It's not perfect, which is good, because then I think that's good, because then I guess I'll make some mistakes and we can learn from that. So I'm just gonna open up this awesome file, which was not activated now, so this was without any mastering. When you bring up Ozone, you're gonna get this thing here, which comes up every time. It's a bit annoying sometimes. I don't know if you can turn that off. But basically, these are a lot of different presets, and it's good to go through, you know, and get someone that you like, and then, you know, see how they have made everything. This is just a compressor. Dynamics means compressor in this case. And the maximizer is the limiter. So we can see just how that sounds. Really loud and bassy, maybe a bit too much bass and low mid for this stuff. Because basically when you are doing like dance, actually I can just show one of my favorite presets here, which I often use in dubstep and then tweak them a bit. These crisp drums, and you can take it with transient recovery. I think I take that one the most. Transient recovery, that's something that's here in the maximizer, the limiter part. Basically, when you get like a kick drum, I think I might be teaching you wrong, because I'm not, grand wizard in this stuff in mastering. But I think I'm decent at it, and that's what I'm gonna show you today, that you can make decent mixes yourself. So. I think that this thing here is gonna like recover your transients that gets lost here in the limiter. That makes sense for me, at least. So I think that's what this one does. And you can just increase it and decrease it. Yeah, that's definitely what it does. I heard some transients here that got increased when I put it up. And I've heard that this one here might be a good thing to turn on, because this basically some things in here can get, you can face some weird problems and weird glitches and stuff, and if you turn this on it removes them. That's all I know, and I think it's the same with this one, so I often just turn these two on. Here to the left are different, mastering modes. They all sound different and have different colors on them. And if you ever, wonder if you can do, like if you want to do something and you see it's missing, just right click and, you can see everything here. You have all these different options for everything. So if you're just, unsure of something, just right click something and it's, here it was, okay, there, you see. It's a lot of different right clicking and stuff here. So I lost track. What I was gonna say before is that in this kind of music, basically this is the curve that you want. You want an EQ that looks like, kill some of the mid and then just boost the high and the low. So basically like this, like a U. If you're gonna, oversaturate it, but just a tiny bit. If you listen to dance music on like flat speakers, I think they're called. When the, yeah, just look up flat frequency response speakers or something like that, then you can hear that the mixing can be pretty bad, and the mastering can be pretty bad, but it still sounds good on most systems. But on those systems, you know, you can hear that it sounds weird, yeah, because of, you know, the way it's compressed and the way it's mixed and mastered, and the equalization, the frequency sounds weird. I need to go to sleep and shut up. But I'm gonna finish this first. Okay, so yeah, the limiter pretty much speaks for itself. It's not too hard to use this. This one though, I suck at compressing, to be honest. So I usually just take a preset and maybe tweak it a bit if I know what I'm doing. But yeah, I suck at compressors. But this is a compressor, and it's a multiband compressor. You probably know what that is. Here's the threshold, and you can use a limiter compressor and a gate. Here you can see the compression being done, and you know all the frequencies and stuff. And here you just add some gain to compensate for the loss of volume when you compress. So yeah, my favorite parts in this is my favorite part, totally. You can make some pretty cool stuff with this, not only in mastering, but you know, if you have a sound that you want to make bigger, is that the way you say it? If you want a sound to get bigger, you can do it with this thing here. Basically, you always want the bass to be mono. In this thing keeps bugging up this text, so it's really annoying, but yeah. Around 250 is good to just keep mono. You can see here that this is not mono. The sub is mono, but the line in the middle, that's the signal being mono. So now everything is mono, but before you could see that there's some weird stuff here when it was on zero. And basically, you increase the width when you pull it up, and you when you pull it down, you decrease it. So this is gonna be totally mono. And then basically you want it to look like this, if you think of this line as width, how wide it's gonna be. So you go from, you know, not wide at all to, you know, a bit more, and then at the end here with the cymbals and stuff, they're just gonna be all over the place. So I'm just gonna, you know, do this very quick and just oversaturate it to so you can see what I mean. Well, I guess this is another really annoying bug. When you sometimes when you solo band like this, it gets soloed in another mode, which is stupid. So now when I solo the bass here, it got soloed in dynamic, so I need to change that. So if you don't hear any sound, that's probably it. Sometimes it doesn't do that, but it still doesn't play any sound. Try soloing a band in the mode that you are in, and then just move this a bit. So you do this, then it might refresh it. It's weird. But yeah, I'm gonna make this really wide. Make that less wide, and then make this even less wide. We're just gonna see what it sounds like. I think it sounds pretty good. I think I use this to, you know, put these bands up too much. I usually have all this on on positive, which is not a good thing, because there's just so much space in the mix. I don't know if I said that right, but you can't put too much stuff, you know, you can't have everything everywhere, of course. So yeah, I think that speaks for itself. Reverb, I know it sounds pretty stupid to have reverb on your master, but sometimes when the, like for example on my track Tripod, I think I used reverb there, because all the sounds were so dry, there was no reverb at all. I think in X-Core's tune Hello, I think he used reverb on the mix, on the master. I'm not sure, but it gives, you know, a special kind of effect when you do that. You need to put this up. And now I'm soloing the wet, because you don't want any bass, so you want to make sure you don't have that. And sometimes you don't even want the high frequencies either. This can be a good tool to use if you have a mix which is lacking some frequencies, like around here. Then you can just fill them in with this. And some pre-delay is good to avoid phasing, I guess, and to make it sound better. Decay time is not going to be a lot. I usually, you know, keep it as low as possible, maybe a bit up. But I keep this down because I don't like the, you know, low. I think the low decay should be really low. The amount, yeah, it should be low. The low decay is basically how long it takes for the low frequencies to the long tail. Oh, the tail of the fuck. You just look that up. I'm breaking my tongue here. Just keep this low. You can keep this a bit off if you want to. It's a bit too long, I think. Yeah, I think that's better. So you can barely hear that, but it just increases, you know, it makes it sound a bit more like you're in a room or something. And this width, you can hear it if you're using good headphones or something. It's barely noticeable, maybe if I put this up. Yeah, now you can hear the difference. I usually put this at like 150 or something, and yeah, that's a good thing. You can double click and just do that. So 150, and pull this down, of course. So that just makes it sound, you know, wider also. So yeah, this reverb is actually overlooked a lot. I like it a lot. Yeah, this part is so cool. This adds like distortion. You can use tape saturation and, you know, tube distortion. You can look those up also if you don't know what that is. But basically, this adds like nice harmonics to the sound. It distorts it like in a tiny. You can put this up, you know, all the way, and then it distorts it a lot. But yeah, I'm just gonna shut up and play you what it sounds like. So you can hear that is too lot, too much. But it adds like a nice warmth if you have this pretty low. This is bypass, by the way. So yeah, let's do that to the bass. That sounds nice. And also, if you wanna remove a band, yeah, just click there. And there's also gonna be somewhere that you can just, you know, have all the options up here, and you can add bands as well. Maybe okay. You have to remove a band and then insert. Okay, that's how it was. Okay. So yeah, let's add some frequencies here too. Yeah, that sounds good. So basically, what a lot of people suggest is that you go up with this until it sounds too, you know, bad. And then just go back. And also, you can mix this in, so you can. That's something that I do for. Okay, this is a 1/6, so I'm just gonna remember that. If you find a place here where it sounds good, for example, maybe if you're doing dubstep and this, you know, 200 peak snare, just it sounds very good on dubstep to do this, because it distorts the snare, you know, the tom snare, the thing. So that sounds very nice if you use this at the low part and also on this part. So here there are some nice frequencies, but it didn't really work in this case, but you know, let's say it did. Then you can mix it in so you get this, but you know, not that loud. Because you oftentimes don't want it to be that loud. So yeah, that's something to think about. I think this was at 1.6, right? 1.6. So yeah, let's see what this sounds like. I think it sounds a bit too cheap up here. Something like that. If I would master this track, I probably wouldn't do it like this, because I would listen to it first and then see what it needed and then add that. Now I'm just adding everything to show you what it can do. Something that I've seen people do is to boost, if the kick and the snare isn't loud enough, you can find where the kick and snare are hitting and then boost there. This is generally a bad idea to do in the mastering process, but it can be done. So I can't really see where my kick is, but I guess it's like here at 100. And kicks, I think all of the time hit at like two places, because they have a tone in them, so they hit at 100 hertz and then half of that down, because that is the same tone or note. So if the kick peaks at if the kick peaks at 100 hertz, then it's also gonna be a peak at 50 hertz. So if you had a kick that's I think it's hitting somewhere here, so let's just say that it does, then we can boost this. This is extreme, you don't want that. Generally in mastering you only want to boost like 1 or 2 or maybe 3 dB, but not more, because that's gonna sound weird. But whatever floats your boat, but yeah, so I'm just gonna see what this sounds like. What the hell? Wait a sec. Ah, okay. This is a low shelf. Okay, so you need to change this. Bell. So yeah, that definitely sounds more bassy. Sometimes what I do is I take this. It's better to just increase the volume of the sub, I guess. But sometimes I put this so that this only affects the sub. And I just increase that. Makes it sound very bassy and nice. So yeah, I think that's it. If you have any questions this can be a good idea to say before. This thing here, if you have wondered, it's basically like a dry wet. So this... Now this isn't activated, like it's the same as turning this off, but you can mix it in. So if you think, for example, the harmonic exciter, if you think that it's giving you some nice overtones, which is what this gives, then you can just decide how much. You can't boost it even more now, I guess, but if you would have this down a bit and you would increase this, the dry wet thing goes up. So let's say that this sounds good, but it's too much, so you just want to add a dry wet, you just pull that down. I think this sounds decent, but I've been sitting with this song for too long now. So, I don't know. That bass sounds so cool. Sounds really like Feed Me... what's the song called? Feed Me Grand Theft Ecstasy. It's a very good track. Okay, so... Jag är klar. That means I am done. So, if you have any questions, just let me know. And I'm gonna end this awkwardly as usual. Bye. See you next time on the other side. Yeah.